Hello, I'm Chris Shunke, the product manager for the Red Hat Learning subscription. In this video, I'll be showing you the features of the standard tier to help you maximize your learning experience. Where we'll start is on the homepage of the learning subscription. Here you'll have access to see some of the newest courses and features added to the subscription, as well as some of your metrics about your use in the subscription. For instance, days remaining, the number of lab hours you've used, the number of student guide downloads you've used, and the number of exams you've used. Note that for the standard tier, you get 400 lab hours, and we'll go into labs a little bit later, and you get 5 exams with 2 unique retakes. We'll also talk about exams when we get to that part. The rest of the homepage also includes the courses that you most recently worked on, so you can easily jump right back into the course that you left off on, including how much progress you had in that course, as well as the different options for versions. So if you want to take a different version than you last left off on, you do have that option. We're going to go ahead and start in the catalog because new subscribers won't have any courses in progress. We're going to need to start a new course. In the catalog, you have access to all of our different offerings. Let's take a look at the filters on the left here to help you select an offering. There are 3 different delivery formats in the catalog. We have courses, exams, and expert extras. We'll talk about those a little later. Let's start with courses. There are currently 53 courses within the subscription. We can further filter to find the right course that you're looking for to achieve your learning goals. For instance, if you're interested in Red Hat OpenShift, perhaps even DevOps, English courses. You can go ahead and we get a list of those here to further filter what you're looking for. Each of the courses listed here includes details if you expand the card. So you can see things like what is this course about, who is the audience, and what are the prerequisites. Each course is available in up to 2 modalities, read and watch. Let's go ahead and start with the read version. This is referred to as our role-based course, ROL, Red Hat Online Learning. And this is a version that consists of text and images and some activities. If you download the student guide, this will be the exact same information in that guide. This version of the course allows you to use the progress bar at the top to go between the different pages. You'll see the content consists of text, some images and references, and also some quizzes and other activities. All of the courses are based around a lab built on Red Hat technology with real Red Hat software. I'm going to go ahead and create our lab because it takes a little bit of time to spin up. So we'll let that build while we talk through the lab experience. If I go back to our course page, each of our chapters have a lab or guided exercise that will take you through the different steps of the lab environment. This is how all of our courses are built. They are built around performing within those Red Hat software labs. At the end of the courses, we have a comprehensive review that will take all of that knowledge you learn throughout the entire course and you'll put it into one long activity where you will work in the lab. The table of contents is also accessible if you need to jump directly to a topic. If I go back to our lab environment, we'll see that these machines are still building. There are 3 machines for this particular lab. We see the status on each of those. An OpenShift lab will also include some of these additional login information details. I do want to point out that our labs have an auto-stop and auto-destroy timer. A lab will auto-stop in order to protect your lab hours. As long as a lab is running, it will count down from your 400 total lab hours. Our labs are set to destroy in 7 days. You can also increase this if you need some more time. Note that a destroyed lab cannot be recovered. So make sure you leave enough days if you're still working in your labs. And again, if you are complete, make sure that you stop your labs so it does not count against your timer. We're going to let these continue to build. I want to show a few other things in the course. We do have a tutorial that talks all about how to use our labs. We also have an ebook for each of our courses. It can be downloaded in various languages. Not all ebook languages are available in all courses. We also include different versions of the course, and these are based on the software version This is version 4.6 of OpenShift, but you'll see we do have other versions depending on what version you are using. Some of our courses also come in various translations. Again, translations will vary depending on the course. Now notice our lab is now complete. Our three virtual machines are now active, and our delete and stop buttons are now available for us. Again, stopping the lab will stop our lab timer, but still make it available to us. Delete will completely destroy the entire lab environment. Throughout the course, you will have instructions on which virtual machine to open. Simply click Open Console, and that will open the machine indicated. I'm going to go ahead and close that tab and point out that each virtual machine also has some additional actions. So you may need to shut down a machine, power it off, or even reset it. And those actions are all available to you on each of those machines. I'm going to go ahead and delete this environment. When you're done with your lab, again, make sure to delete it so the lab hours do not count against your total time. I'm going to now return to the catalog and talk about our second modality in the subscription, and that is the watch modality. This is referred to as our video classroom. Video classroom is the exact same content as our role-based version. The difference is that these are built by recording our instructors teaching this content. So if you prefer to listen to an instructor teach the content while they give examples and show demonstrations, this modality is the right one for you. The great thing is both of these modalities are available in the subscription. You don't have to choose. You get both of them. A few additional things I want to point out in our video classroom. So we do include transcripts so you can follow along with the instructor. There's also closed captioning, and this is available in various languages. All these languages are available in all of our video classroom videos. The lab environment is the exact same that we showed in the role course. You can also search for various terms inside the video classroom. So you'll see if I search for Java, that's found in many different pages, and this points to the exact part of the video where that's located. Lastly, you can download the ebook from the video classroom as well. While the catalog does offer many ways to find the right courses based on the category or product that you're working on, the learning subscription also offers skills paths. Skills paths offer a set of courses and exams that help you achieve Red Hat certification. So if you're interested in Red Hat Certified System Administrator and Red Hat OpenStack, simply launch this skills path and you'll see that it's made up of two courses, a preliminary exam, and then the final exam, ultimately leading towards certification. If you're interested in a skills path, simply enroll. And what this will do, if I go back to my homepage, you'll see this will be listed on my skills paths, so you can follow along with the progress of your path. This path, we are 26% of the way through, and that's because we've worked through some of the two courses available. Once the exams and the courses are all complete, this skills path will be complete. As mentioned, skills paths are also made up of exams. You can view the exam from the skills path to see all the details. So it includes the audience, prerequisites, things you need to do to prepare for this exam. There may be more than one version of the exam, so make sure you select the version that you'd like to take, and then simply enroll in the exam. This will take you to our exam scheduler, where you will fill out a date and time to take your exam. Note that many of our exams are now available remote, so you do not have to take them in a physical location. You can take them from your home. If I return to the catalog, you will see if I select delivery formats and exams, we get to look at all of the exams here, and you can see which ones have remote availability. I mentioned before that the subscription includes expert extras, so let's go ahead and click on those. Expert extras are supplemental video content that offers some in-depth look at different technologies and topics. They can also be filtered by various products. So for instance, if you're interested in OpenShift, DevOps content, you get to see all of the expert extras that deal with those two topics. Launching it will bring up a video, and you'll get some details about what the presenter is talking about. So this is really great to dig into some of those extra supplemental content areas that you might be interested in that aren't necessarily covered in the course. Your subscription comes with a dashboard where you can track your progress and look at some of your metrics. If you look at the top, you'll see some of the various metrics within the subscription. For instance, the number of videos you've watched, the number of pages you've read, how many total hours you've spent within the subscription. There's also track of the number of downloads and exams you've taken, as well as lab hours and how many days you have left. At the bottom, this is where you will track your progress in courses and labs. We can use some filters in here to find just the courses that are complete, for instance. And you'll see those listed here. Any complete course will also allow you to get your certificate for that course. And this is done by going to our Red Hat Learning community. You can launch any course from here by clicking read or watch, and also see the details listed with this course. The latest version will be the one to show, so you may need to click to a different version, for instance, if you selected a course that's complete. So you'll see version 3.9 was completed. That's why it's listed here. You can also show things like labs, if you want to see how much time you've spent in the various courses in the lab environment. And then you can jump right to that course to continue in the lab. The subscription also includes early access. The early access catalog consists of courses that are currently in progress, so you can see the progress of our course authors. This lets you get a sneak peek of courses that are coming, and also lets you look at some of the content for those courses. So we'll see there is some content that is in progress and some that's not ready yet. Users can give feedback about this content, so our authors can fix these bugs and fix these issues before the course is officially released. And the great thing for our users is you can see what's coming. Learning Subscription Standard also comes with our expert chat feature. This chat window will let you talk to our Red Hat experts about various topics, including technical issues, as well as questions about your course content. So if you're in the middle of a course and you're struggling with the content, feel free to send a message to our course experts using Expert Chat Course Assistance. Experts are there to help you so you're not stuck in your course. As mentioned, you can also get additional support on technical issues and your exams. Thank you so much for viewing this demonstration of the Red Hat Learning Subscription.